"It is the nature of a stone to be satisfied," poet Mary Oliver once wrote. "It is the nature of a river to want to be somewhere else." These places in transition, where the land and the water embrace, are home to tiny critters responsible for a climate solution that could be our Earth's saving grace. Can we unlock the hidden potential of wetlands microbes? Find out in this episode of Our World by Degrees. Missouri is home to 500,000 acres of wetlands, where water saturates the soil, including the backwaters of the mighty Mississippi, where twice a year, biologist Arpita Bose and her team collect wild microbes.
One thing that humans are attracted to is water. And I realized that we haven't even scratched the surface of what we have on this planet that would provide solutions, things that we haven't thought of yet.
One teaspoon of soil can hold millions of microbial species. Not only are these tiny organisms diverse, they naturally eat carbon dioxide and create energy. It's all part of their larger process to transfer carbon from the atmosphere and safely store it in the soil for thousands of years.
People care about microorganisms because they cause disease. But I was like, what about all of the other ones that are all around us that don't? Why can't we study those and then figure out, you know, how we could fix some of our problems? Maybe they have answers for us already.
Back in her lab at Washington University, Bose is interested in finding ways to replace petrochemicals using the power of microbes to make fuels.
We have shown that we can engineer these kinds of microorganisms in the lab to make biofuels. Nature has done this for us through evolutionary time. You just have to go harness them from these wetlands.
Bose's team are feeding wetland microbes using electricity from solar power and coaxing them into producing small amounts of N-butanol. The result, a liquid biofuel, is more efficient than other fuels like ethanol. And unlike fossil fuels, this fuel is carbon neutral. But can these microorganisms produce enough energy to power the automobiles of the future? Bose thinks so.
I think public thinking is completely changing. There's this consulting group at WashU called BALSA. It's a completely graduate student-led organization. They have helped me do cost analyses and market analyses on the different molecules that we were targeting. I think that biofuels being made or biocommodities being made using these kinds of microorganisms is going to be a game changer.
New knowledge about the role of soil microbes in healthy wetlands is also helping conservation efforts.
A lot of times we think about wetlands in terms of cattail and water, and that's one form of a wetland, but wetlands are really diverse.
Ecologist Frank Nelson collaborates with Bose on wetland soil studies across Missouri in unique landscapes like Fins, where groundwater saturates the soil.
The great thing about wetlands is the amount of organic carbon that's in the soil. And so when you've got carbon, you basically have a buffet for microbes.
Wetlands help purify water, act as natural shock absorbers during floods, and provide a home to plants and animals. Yet for centuries, wetlands have been viewed as wastelands, drained for development or agriculture.
You know, wetlands in Missouri were a lot more prevalent. We've lost nearly 90% of what we once had. And even though there's been gains in the last 60 and 30 years in terms of wetland conservation, there's a lot more we could do.
We can do it for future generations. People like Bose's daughter. Preserving wetlands preserves the microbes and helps stabilize environmental conditions. These once plentiful wetland ecosystems may yet offer new and undiscovered climate solutions.
We have to talk about Missouri soils, Missouri wetlands, and we have to get this out there for people who can, use this knowledge and share it and develop it and keep investing our energy into it. I think that it's going to take the actions of many people from fields that we do not even think are connected at all to make this truly a way that the planet could be sustainable.